Welcome back to the Artie Lang Show, 888-936-8822. My name is Mike Calta, filling in for Artie Lang. He'll be back here tomorrow. I am here with Robert Kelly and NBC Sports' Kay Adams, and we're sitting with Tom Cotter, who is in town, going to be playing at the Newton Theater in New Jersey on Saturday. What is it, like a 2,000-seater?
I don't even know how many seats are in that place.
Well, the only reason why I ask is because that's the natural progression, to do comedy clubs for a whole weekend and then move on to do theaters, which instead of doing, what, you'll probably get banged for a Friday night, two Friday, two Saturday, and then the dreaded Sunday show, or maybe even a Thursday night show. Ugh. And now you could get rid of all that crap and do one theater show, hit as many people, and probably make more money.
Robert knows this as well. It's all C's. It's corporations, colleges, cruise ships, casinos, and comedy clubs. And these two, colleges and corporations, have the deepest pockets. So they're not going to make you famous. I got to do Chick-fil-A's big thing on Saturday.
Right.
On Sunday,
but
right?
That's big money, right? Corporate gigs, yeah.
But you talked about off the air about being clean, squeaky clean, because they're not open on Sundays. And they're
Chick-fil-A. Yeah.
So I'm a little nervous about that one. I got to really be
your
Disney
knees,
clean.
Your knees wobble.
Yeah, exactly.
And I had to do a corporate in Vegas, and I was petrified. And then all of a sudden you do them, and usually when you're done, you're like, oh, that was nothing. Yeah. It was great. And then you get that check, and you're like, oh, my God. Yeah.
I have a question for you guys. Speaking of being petrified, what's worse, like crickets when you're performing or heckling?
That's a good question.
I would prefer heckling just because you're getting a response.
Like, is crickets just the bar none worst pits?
Well, I have a lot of energy, so cricket, there's nothing worse than an energetic comic, and you go through all your stuff, blue, blah, and then nothing at the end. It's like you're sweating, you're hyperventilating, and there's usually a laugh, and there's just people looking at you. That's the worst.
Does that happen a lot to you?
I'd rather have you stink so I could just attack them.
I concur. I agree. I'd much rather have someone come at me, because at least they're interacting with you,
Do you miss the? I mean, like back. Remember in Boston when we did it? Oh my God, we'd do like five shows a night.
Mm-hmm.
Upstairs Knicks, downstairs Knicks. Do the Comedy Connection, run over to Dick Doherty's, and then they had duck soup or whatever the improv over there, and it was crazy. But now you're doing these theaters, which are great. But don't you miss the clubs? Don't you miss being right in the right level with the fans?
I still do them. I'm doing the improv in Fort Lauderdale coming up, and that's a club.
Yeah.
It's at the Hard Rock. It's fun. I'm not plugging it. I'm just telling you. It's way, I wanted to tell you what it is. But I like clubs. I still love clubs. I still love going back to clubs.
Do you take an opener in the theaters?
When I have to. When they ask me, I always have to ask my wife first.
That's what I was going to say, because then you have to kind of ask your wife.
If Rich Foss was here right now, I'd be like, I do, too. I bring my wife.
He does.
Bonnie goes up.
He brings
up.
Bonnie. And Al Ducharme brings Bernadette Pauly. So, when there are some married couples, that's another one.
Yeah.
And on stage is the only place my wife still opens for me. Hello. But, when, she has to stay home with the kids, then I get to bring an opener, or the club will get one. You just don't want someone who's, horribly filthy.
That's what I'm saying. Do you bring a guy that you know that you like, or do they assign somebody? Like, how does it usually work?
I have, like we all do, I have guys who swing the bat for me, and they kind of thin the herd and make sure that way I'm not. It's good cop, bad cop.
Right,
I'm not the guy saying I don't want to work with that guy. I just don't want someone to, spoil the room before I get up there.
Has your wife ever killed it in front of you? Were you like, oh, boy?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
So she
absolutely.
Have you ever, done not as good because she just leveled the room?
Robert, countless times.
Really?
Yeah, because especially if it's a lot of women in the crowd, because they just dig what she does.
Yeah.
And then I got to get up there and my, misogynistic self and just lay an egg.
How old are these kids of yours?
The twins are 11 and the youngest is 6.
At what age do you let them witness the filth?
Unfortunately, the internet is out there, and they're going to discover some stuff that I'm not proud of that's out on the internet right now.
How do you handle that?
We're going to have a come to Jesus eventually, but they haven't found it yet. So until they do, I'm
hiding
in the weeds.
I have a question as a father that I care about. When did your kids realize that you were cool? When you were on America's Got Talent, or when you almost won? Like, I would imagine when they go to school and the kids are like, is your dad on TV? That's got to be a great feeling.
That was probably the magnum opus of that whole thing. But before that, they equated what I did with a rodeo clown. They couldn't understand what a stand-up comic was.
They don't get it. They're kids.
They just thought I allegedly made people laugh, or people laughed at me.
Right.
And not necessarily a good thing, because in school, don't laugh at people. And then
because they probably don't find you funny whatsoever.
No, not at all.
There's nothing you could do to your own kids to make them like you. I go through this all the time. I have to attach myself to pictures of famous wrestlers and rock stars, and then I run home and I go, look now. And still, he's like, oh, The Rock and you. Yeah, that's the feeling that I get all the time.
And you and the riffraff with The Rock.
Yeah. Tom Cotter is going to be at the Newton Theater in New Jersey on Saturday. Check him out. He's very funny. Can you weigh in on this for us as we put together this bracket? First of all, tell me, because they don't have to be the same answer. Who is your favorite like comedian that made you kind of want to do this? And is that the same or other like maybe top three of all time?
Well, you mentioned before, I used to sneak albums. This is how old I am now. Yeah. Record albums into my house and listen to George Carlin and Richard Pryor. George Carlin's Indecent Exposure and Richard Pryor's Live on the Sunset Strip or whatever the hell it was. And at the time, I could recite them verbatim.
Right.
And I would frequently do that and get sent to the principal's office because they were filthy. And if my parents knew I had them, I would have been grounded. But those are the two that really got me intrigued.
And did you know from doing that that this might be something that you wanted to do at a young age?
I was, you know, I'm the youngest of six kids in an Irish Catholic family, so you do anything you can to get attention.
I just wanted,
look at me, you know, so class clown begets a cocky guy at college who thinks he's funny, and then that begets the stand-up comedy thing.
Go ahead.
We're going to eliminate one of these comedians. You're going to do this. We can make our bracket. Robin Williams or Steve Martin? Who gets the boot?
Just say it. I got to eliminate Robin Williams
really?
On that one.
Yes,
yeah.
Exactly. Sorry, Dan.
You're fired.
I don't find anything funny about Robin Williams stand-up wise. I think he's a great comedic actor.
Yeah.
But there's just a lot of and that's not funny to me. Isn't that what it is?
It's not a bad Robin Williams.
Yeah, because that's all he got. That's a and a little of that and a couple of noises. It's a clown. He's a clown without makeup. But he's been great and successful in movies. I'm not taking that away.
Steve Martin.
Who will get eliminated later on. I guarantee you.
He's not at the top of the food chain either in my book, but that's just not my cup of tea. You know?
Yeah, he will get eliminated.
Bill Cosby ain't going nowhere, fellas.
What else you got?
Sam Kinison.
And who else?
Eddie Murphy. That's the one that you guys don't like either. Boston Eddie Murphy.
You know, I used to, senior year of college, Raw came out. Raw came out, and then after that was Delirious.
No, Delirious first, then Raw.
Yeah. Okay, so.
Delirious was the red leather suit. Yeah. Raw was the purple paisley suit.
We know what you were looking at.
Who wouldn't look at that?
To me, I saw him pull up in a limo. I saw him get out and, you know, like a concert. And I was I might want to try that, you know. Sans the leather suit, but
he's a rock star. He's a rock.
Yeah,
he's a rock star comedy
rock star.
Yeah, he's one of those rock star. Pryor was a rock star comedy.
Yeah,
a comic.
Don't answer the Kinison. Who was it? Kinison. Who else? Pryor.
Kinison. Eddie Murphy.
All right, don't answer that. We'll talk about that when we come back from break, and we'll take your phone calls. 888-936-8822. Tom, good luck to you. It's good to
thank you
to
guys.
See you.
Thanks for having me.
Enjoy
great to see
the Newton Theater. Go see Tom Cotter on Saturday. We will take a quick break and come back.
The Artie Lang Show, weeknights on Audience, only on DirecTV.